elephant in the room first. And the elephant in the room is, what happened? How come this year feels different than other years? Why did the market, the S&P, which is a measure of the top 500 companies in the US, why did it do so well the first half of the year? Why did it not do well in other years? What should we expect going forward? Those are the questions everybody usually has. And in order to understand it, let's go back a little bit in time. Everybody remember 2008? 2008 was a really bad year in the stock market. The S&P dropped about 37%. Half of 2009 was also a bad year. And there was a recession. And one of the ways that the country solved the recession was by changing interest rates or reducing interest rates. The Federal Reserve, which is the organization that is in charge of interest rates, started lowering interest rates. They went from a very high percentage to nothing, zero. Anybody remember 6% CDs? Not that long ago. What happened was the Federal Reserve started lowering interest rates. So you would think, okay, well, they're lowering interest rates. What does that mean? When interest rates are lower, it means that corporations and banks can borrow or access money cheaply. So imagine your ExxonMobil, your IBM, your Apple, and you want to build a project, or you want to build a plant, or you want to open some new stores, or whatnot. If you can get cash cheap, you can build, because cash is money, and cash is the energy, the fuel that drives companies. Anybody who's a small company knows there's something called cash flow. You don't have enough cash flow, you're in trouble. So I like to do it this way. In 2010, in 2011, you're on a boat, you're in the Keys, and oh, by the way, you like to fish. You're in the Keys, and you like to fish, and you have a boat, it's an okay boat, but it has a wood bottom, a dark wood bottom, and the day is calm. You know, there's nothing in the sky, and you have one fishing pole in the line, you're a little nervous. Because you know what, it used to be really rough, 2008, it used to be really rough. And you're saying, oh, maybe there's gonna be fish. Every so often you'll catch a fish and feel good, but you feel like it's luck rather than skill. Meanwhile, underneath, unbeknownst to you, the Federal Reserve is planting coral. They're making coral reefs. And they're still putting a lot of coral down, and it's attracting fish. You know, coral drives fish, because that's the food for fish. Coral, by the way, is the Federal Reserve, and the banks, and corporations. The fish are the stock companies rising. And every so often, you will land a fish. So up to November 7th, 2016, you're on this boat, you might be catching fish, you don't know what's going on. And then all of a sudden, we had a change of regime. Remember the change of regime? We had President Trump elected. Now, I know some people in the room here thought that Trump would be elected. Most people did not, but some people did. And all of a sudden, President Trump said, before he got elected, I want to deregulate banks, I want to reduce corporate taxes. I want to make it a very pro-business environment. Everybody agree that that's his goal?
Yeah.
If he does that, you're on the boat on November 7th. The boat you have with a dark bottom you can't see is magically and suddenly replaced by a glass bottom boat. And you can see the coral and the fish, and you go, oh my gosh, look at all these fish. How many lines are you going to drop in the water? As many as you can. Now, I said that I'm cautiously optimistic about what's going on in the market. That's because all of a sudden I can see all the fish.